Hello and welcome to 5 Minutes to Code with your host Matthew C. Applegate. Today we are going to be looking at some examples in processing. I love using processing to help new programmers learn how to code. It's simple and it gives the coder almost immediate feedback, which allows them to better understand what the code is doing. If you don't already have processing, I recommend you pause the video and download it from the link below. Once you have processing set up, you're ready to begin. Processing is set up into two main areas, the setup area and the draw area. As the program is run, it jumps to the setup area and carries out those instructions first. It only does this once at the beginning of the program. After it has completed the instructions in the setup area, it moves on to the draw area. The draw area loops from top to bottom until the program is terminated. Let's check out the code for this example in more detail. Today, we are going to create some more generative computer art. The first thing we need to do is create some global variables at the top here. So we're going to declare float parts and float p. The first command of the setup area is to set the application screen size. So we do that by using the command size 650 by 500. We now need to use the command parts equal random 12 to 36. This will generate a random number between 12 and 36. We now need to convert that number from a float with a decimal point into an integer by using parts equal int parts. And finally, in the setup area, we need to decide what the size is of each part. We do that by using this following calculation. P equals pi times 2 divided by parts. Pi times 2 is a full circle, and we divide that by the number of parts that we have created. Now with our canvas set up, let's move on to the draw area. The first command we issue is background 000, and that draws the background black. The 000 are R, G, and B values. 0 red, 0 green, and 0 blue equals black. Now we are going to get it to draw this shape 10 times on top of each other. So that's why we have a for loop here, for int j to equal 0 to j equals less than 10. We also need it to draw the full shape. So we create I equals 0 to I is less than parts. Our next command, fill random 255, random 255, and random 255, and random 128, will actually create a random color and random opacity for our brush. The fill command is used to change the color of the inside of shapes. We do a similar operation here with the stroke command, which draws the outline of the shapes. We now draw the shape 10 times on top of each other to get a nice blended effect by using the arc command. We randomize the size of it between 200 and 1500 to get a nice randomly generated shape. And finally, the last command, delay 3000, delays the program 3000 milliseconds or 3 seconds before the process starts all over again and creates another piece of work. This should give you a nice blended piece of generative computer art. I really hope you like it. Be sure to tinker with the code. Change some of the examples. Make the screen bigger or smaller. Change the size of the brush. Even change the way the color is randomized for different results. Remember to take screenshots of your art and maybe try and recreate some of your work in the real world. I really hope you like what you have seen. And if you do, be sure to like, subscribe, and comment down below. If you want more, be sure to check out the other videos in the series. There's lots of great examples to help you create computer art.